The Metro Manila Development Authority points to non-functioning pumping stations in Manila as the cause of flooding in some areas. Lady Vicencio reports.
The Metropolitan Manila Development Authority says repairs in three pumping stations in Manila contributed to flash floods in parts of Manila following Friday's heavy rains. The MMDA explains these stations are part of the Dolomite Beach project. They are being used as a drainage output where water can be treated before they are discharged to Manila Bay.
Ang area na, ang catchment area niyan, itong Tap, itong Malate, yung mga binahang lugar.
Sa ngayon kasi ayaw ipa-discharge directly yung tubig na gagaling sa area dahil untreated kasi yun eh. So mapupollute yung tubig sa area. Gusto natin na maging swimmable.
The MMDA is also advising the public to prepare for recurring floods until repairs are done. As a temporary measure, mobile pumps will be deployed to inundated areas to siphon flood waters. In the meantime, Public Works and Highway Secretary Manuel Bonoan says lack of funds caused the delays in finishing the repairs. The DPWH also conducted declogging along Taft Avenue.
Ito naman po requirement kasi ng DENR na dapat natin proteksyonan yung Dolomite Beach para hindi madumihan. Actually, baka makakumpuni ho namin lahat ito by middle of September or latest end of September po.
Incessant rains last week submerged parts of the capital, making it a nightmare for commuters and motorists to get home. The Manila City LGU says if flooding happens again, it will offer free rides to stranded commuters.
Automatic na po, pagka malakas ang ulan, ang ating pong kapulisan, ang MDRRMO and ang MTPB po ay nagbibigay po ng libreng sakay. Of course, continuous pa rin pong mga declogging namin sa buong Kamaynilaan.
Lady Vicencio, ABS-CBN News.
9 people have been killed and 7 others remain missing in Seoul as the South Korean capital saw its worst rainfall in decades. Dramatic images shared on social media showed people wading through waist-deep water, subway stations overflowing, and cars half submerged in the posh Gangnam district. It also caused landslides and power outages in other areas. Authorities warn more rains are on the forecast. President Yoon Suk-yeol blamed the record rainfall on climate change and said the government needed to adapt. Meanwhile, the Philippine Foreign Affairs Department says there have been no reports of Filipinos affected by the flooding in Seoul. It adds the Philippine Embassy there is monitoring the situation. Well, last month marked one of the hottest Julys on record. The World Meteorological Organization says global temperatures measured nearly half a degree above the average. That's despite the ongoing La Nina weather phenomenon, which is meant to have a cooling influence, continuing almost uninterrupted since September 2020. The European summer has seen extreme heat waves and drought, with low rainfall records broken in some countries. Last month, the weather agency warned heat waves like the ones baking Western Europe are becoming more frequent and may become the norm in decades to come.